In this video, I'm going to show you how to make an Android app with no coding experience using just one AI tool, and we're going to do it in minutes. Now, you may have seen my previous video about making iOS apps using only AI. It went down really well, and a lot of you asked for an Android tutorial. In fact, I got Android. What about Android? How about Android? So here is that tutorial. Let's dive in. Before we do, just a quick one, if you could like and subscribe to the channel, it really helps it to grow. I noticed recently that most of you who watch my videos are not subscribed, so please hit the subscribe button, ding the bell, and never miss another tutorial like this one. Okay, let's dive in. And first of all, we're going to start off by downloading Android Studio. Now you can install it by dragging and dropping into applications or running the executable if you're on Windows. Now I've loaded up Android Studio. I've never seen this before, but don't worry, it'll be really easy to get started. So first of all, let's go through the setup wizard and click Next. What type of setup do I want? Let's go for the standard. It's good to agree to all the current settings, including an Android emulator, which basically mimics a real Android phone on your computer if you don't have access to one yourself. Click Next. Go ahead and accept all the terms, click finish, let it do its installing. Okay, with that done, we're into the new app interface here. So I just simply select new project to get started. And we'll start off with the default empty activity. Now I need to give the application a name. I'm going to call it Best Bike Day, like that. And then we need to give it a package name. Now this is similar to the iOS, it's just your domain name backwards. So if you had example.com, it's com.example. For me, it's fm.mrc. And then the save location, well, you can choose a different location if you like. I've actually just changed it to appear on my desktop. Now we can choose the minimum SDK. And again, let's just leave that as the default. Everything else can be left. So let's click finish. And there is my Best Bike Day app folder, and we're now loading into the Android Studio interface. And much like Xcode, when developing iOS apps, you've got a similar interface. Let's hide that panel. We've got code on the right-hand side, and we've got a structure of where all that code is on the left-hand side. Don't worry, we're not going to need to touch that code or go really much further for the moment in Android Studio. Now we'll load our AI tool called Cursor. It's insane. Let's load it up and link it to the Android Studio project. This is the AI tool that's going to write all the code for us. We click open a folder, and then you need to select the folder that's there on the desktop, in my case called Best Bike Day. And now you'll see on the screen, I have linked my Cursor AI tool to the Android Studio app I just created. So Cursor can see all the initial files here and edit them. So let's go ahead and do that. And I'm going to open Cursor Composer, which will write all the code for my app for me by hitting Command, Shift, and I on my Mac, or Control, Shift, I on your PC. And then you can type the instructions in and get Cursor to start creating that app. Now I'm going to start really simple by at tagging the code base. This is so that Cursor can see all the files Android Studio created. And then I type in natural language, what I want the app to do. And I'm going to start simple. I'm going to go step by step. I'm going to say Best Day for Bike Ride app. Number one, it needs to use an API to get local weather conditions for the next 7 days and display them on screen. Don't worry, we can do the rest of the stuff later. Let's just see if we can do one simple thing. Hit enter and away we go. It's going to start searching through all of the files, choose the ones it needs to edit, and then decide what it needs to do, and even start writing the code so that the app can do exactly what I've asked it to do. Okay, we seem to have a nicely written piece of code already here in Android Studio. Let's test it out on a virtual Android device by clicking the play button to run the app on a virtual device here on my screen. Now it's going to think about it for a moment and then pop open a new window with an Android device on my computer. And yes, have a look at this. We have weather for Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. So a nice 7-day forecast exactly as I've requested. Let's take this data and further crunch it to turn it into a useful bike riding Android app. Now, this is just glossing over the surface. We go into detail on how to build Android apps using only AI in my community, which is linked up down below. Okay, back in Cursor Composer, I'm tagging the code base again to say that I want to make these specific updates. One, make an algorithm that combines the weather conditions, temperature, rain chance, and wind speed, create a percentage score on how good that day is for a bike ride, and display 7 days with a percentage score on how good it is. 0% being rubbish, and 100% is perfect. Let's let Cursor go back to work, searching through the files it needs to make changes to, and writing the code for me right here in front of my eyes. Okay, so it's making that advanced algorithm. Now it's updating the weather card to display that specific biking score that I'm looking for. And it's done. Let's accept all and go back over to the Android Studio. And here I can simply stop the app and then restart it by hitting play. Boom, it's loading in. And wow, look at that. It's given me a percentage score. And I didn't even ask for this, but it's given me a circle around the score showing exactly how good the days are for biking here. Looking pretty interesting. I absolutely love the layout of this app so far, but I think I can improve the visuals a bit. So let's do that back in Cursor. So I'm saying here, can you color code the weather cards from red rubbish to green perfect and all colors in between for the bike score percentage? Also, make the app look really pretty. Okay, it's helping enhancing the UI, as it says here. It's writing all the code for that. It's going to make those updates, and we'll have a look at what it's done. And boom, that is that. Accept all, and we'll go back to Android Studio again. Okay, back here in Android Studio, we'll click refresh to restart the app, and let's see the changes it's made. Wow, now that is a really cool looking app. It's given me all the days of the week with nice icons, the temperature, the rain chance, the wind speed, best day for biking, and of course everything here with my current location is green. Yes, perfect conditions for biking right now. Let's try a different location that maybe has more variable weather to see if this app really works. I've said, can you change the weather location to Dubai in this app? Back over, we'll refresh the app again and have a look at Dubai. And here we go. Yes, Dubai is not very good for Thursday, Friday, Saturday and Sunday. But actually, you know what? Monday and Tuesday, those are banger days. Those are the days to get out and hit the trail. If you like what you see so far, throw a like on this video and subscribe for more tutorials just like this one. So this is great. I've designed an app in just a few minutes that I can run on my Android phone. But now I'd like to actually get it onto my Android phone so I can put it in my jersey pocket and take it with me and know the best time to cycle. Let's do that. To make this work, of course, you'll need a cable that you will plug into the bottom of your Android phone and the other end into your computer. First, I need to go to Settings, then About Phone. Scroll all the way to the build number and tap it 7 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Enter my PIN. And boom, I'm now a developer, apparently, according to my phone. Next, I need to enter developer options in the Settings menu on my phone and switch on USB debugging. It's going to say, are you sure? I'll say yes. And now if I head back to Android Studio and go into Device Manager, you'll see my Google Pixel 5, that's the phone I connected to my computer, now shows up and I can click the play button. Oh man, this is super epic. All of the best bike days are listed here on my phone. I can now put this phone in my jersey pocket, take it with me, and I'll never be caught out by the wind or the rain again. Okay, first I'm going to design the app icon really quickly, and I'm going to do that in Midjourney. So I've got that loaded up now, Imagine, and then I've generated a prompt using AI. It even uses hex colors and really detailed prompting techniques. So I'll just prompt the Midjourney bot. And here we go. Here's a few little prototypes I've got. I quite like the first one here, so I'm going to upscale it and take it. Now, most AI image generators tend to love to leave a white space and curved edges around those app icons. But no worries, I can just zoom this in like so, and maybe use a little bit of generative fill to get rid of those little white splodges at the edge, like so. And there's our app icon, which I'm going to save out as a PNG file. And actually, the size needs to be 512 by 512. So let's make sure that's exactly correct. Okay, now it's time to add my app icon to the app itself. Inside Android Studio, right-click this res folder, go to new and look for image asset. And then here you'll see a little folder down here under the path area. And you just want to go to your desktop and find it. There it is. Add it. And look, that all looks pretty nice. That's going to be my app icon and it's ready to go. Let's click next and then finish. Now, just by the fact that I've hit play on Android Studio, it's actually built and downloaded the app to my phone. So I can use this now as I wish in the future. But say I want to share it with friends, I can go to the build menu, build app bundle slash APKs, build APK, and then look, it's done. As simple as that, click locate. It's going to open up a folder on my computer where the APK exists. Now, if I want, I can rename this to something more meaningful. And now I can actually take that APK file and share it with whomever I want. I'm not locked into an app store. Yes, I can upload it to the Google Play Store, but just sending the APK to a friend will allow them to also install this app on their Android device. Pretty cool, huh? There you go. Now you're an Android developer thanks to AI. It really is as simple as that to make your first Android app ever using one AI tool and just a few minutes of your time. Let me know how you get on in the comments down below. I'll be there cheering you on, supporting you, and helping you as much as I can. And if you want to do a deeper dive, go ahead and join my community. The link is down below in the description and the comments, and I'll see you there to discuss this further. And by the way, there's a video showing on your screen now that you should probably watch next. Thanks.